Welcome back to Caleb the Video Maker 2. In this video, we are finally installing ClusterControl. I know this has taken so long, but now we have such a good foundation that when we're working with ClusterControl, we actually know what we're doing a little bit. So let's go to our ClusterControl virtual machine that we set up in the previous videos. And I already have the guide up here teaching you how to install it. And I'm literally just going to follow this guide, so it's nothing crazy. The URL for this is you can just go to the Several Nines website /docs/getting-started-with-a-hyphen.html if you want to follow along. And I'll try to put that URL down in the description. All right, so let's just type in these commands that it's telling us to do. There's the first one. Done. Now, chmod plus x install hyphen cc. Oh, that was easy. /install-cc. And this, you can see here, it says as root or sudo user. So what that means is we need to go back to the beginning and type in sudo and then press enter. Now we need to type in our password. And this is going to give you a lot of prompts with questions. A lot of these are really not that important. I'm going to point out the ones that are most important, but just do what you think is right in this situation. Like, do you want to send diagnostics data? That's totally up to you. While this is working, let me just explain this little blue box down here. You can see it says ClusterControl relies on a MySQL server as a data repository, blah, 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 blah. Essentially what that means is ClusterControl itself needs a database to store data that the application uses. So this is different than the database you're going to be using for your actual database cluster. Essentially, this is the database that ClusterControl uses for its own information. So throughout this installation, if you don't already have MySQL installed, it's going to ask you a bunch of questions about setting it up and the kind of username and password you want. That's all fine, just make sure you write down any information it asks for, so that way if you need it in the future, you can get that. It's also going to ask you a bunch of questions about like security and yada yada, it's recommended to do this. And well, because I'm in a testing environment, I really don't care about security. But if you are practicing for a production environment, you probably want to be a little bit more careful with the security. But one of the things that I know it's going to ask is about validating passwords. And essentially what that's going to do is make sure your passwords are secure enough. That one in particular, I'm going to say no to because I use a super insecure password for all this stuff. So that way I don't forget it. But basically everything else I'm going to say yes to. That's all I'm going to need from this guide, so I'm just going to X out of this, and that'll allow me to put this in full screen. There we go. You know, I actually think I like it like this a little bit better. Oh, here I am shaping the thing and it's asking me a question. Okay, so this is really important. You can see that it says detected more than one IP, and that's because in VirtualBox we gave it 2 network cards. The one we are wanting to use is this 10.71.34.101, but by default, it's going to use 10.0.2.15. So we do want to change this. So make sure you put Y for yes, and then type in that new IP address, 10.71.34.101. All right, so this is installing. It asks me some port information with MySQL. I'm just using the default for everything. This part, take note, you gotta remember your passwords. That's literally why I make all my passwords password. One of these questions is reloading the privilege tables. I'm going to put yes for that. You can read, it says, this will ensure that all changes made so far will take effect immediately. So that's obviously something we're going to wanna do. So ClusterControl has a MySQL user called come on. Gotta make sure you give it a password. All right, it's done. There is one line you want to pay particular attention to, and that is this line right here. Open your web browser to, and then it gives you a link. You can actually hold control and click that. That'll open up Firefox. Okay, so this is going to be the front end of your Several Nines application. And when you open it, it's going to have you create a username and password, or an email and password, I should say. Once you create your account, you're going to get to this page and there's going to give you some information. Who cares about that? We can just X out of that. And this is the home page. So the very first thing you're probably going to want to do is hold control and press D to bookmark it. That way you can always find it. So there we go, guys. We set up ClusterControl. In the next video, we are going to actually be setting up a cluster inside of ClusterControl. And that's going to be, you know, the the best part of this series. So I'll see you then. And if you've enjoyed these videos, please be sure to subscribe, send them to your friends. And once again, if my audio is horrible, I apologize. I'm running like 3 virtual machines inside of my laptop that's already noisy by default. So there's not a whole lot I can do about it in this situation. So yeah, I'll see you all in the next video. Peace out.